So I think no man in a century will suffer as greatly as you will.
Not to 50! I am Luke. Today on Out of Darts, we are checking out Eazy-E's mythical 50-round drum mag. Now, it's sort of self-proclaimed as mythical, and I have to say I kind of agree with him. The amount of engineering and thought and just obsession that went into creating this 3D-printed magazine is pretty mind-boggling. There really hasn't been a successful drum magazine for a Talon magwell. This is your standard 15-round Talon mag in comparison. We've of course gone larger. This is our Coda mag. So a little comparison, you can see a Coda mag is a little bit longer than this drum mag just for a size reference. At the end of the day, no one's done this. We've had drum mags all the way up to 50 for full-length darts, but doing it for short darts is probably a little bit more challenging, and doing it in a 3D print is even more impressive. So Ezekiel, thank you for sending this out to me. I am really excited to play around with it. As you can probably see, you can see through the entire mag. There is a bumper on the bottom that allows it to take hits. Very cool concept. It is a very heavy magazine compared to just a standard stick mag. So if it dropped on the ground, likely it's gonna drop that direction. You've got this nice TPU thermoplastic, just a softer plastic to give some give so that can hit without breaking the entire mag or cracking open the assembly. Now, the magazine, a lot like some real magazines, actually requires a loading mechanism and a rather complicated loading process. And I don't think this is avoidable because it is just crazy, the engineering that went into doing this. But we're gonna go ahead and stumble through my first time loading this. Like little hieroglyphics here, we've got a guide on exactly how to load it. So it tells you exactly what to do, and I'm just gonna go through step by step. We've got our second camera here that will hopefully catch all of this detail. I'll try to do this down on the table here, but we're gonna go ahead and load it up. So first step there is to insert the key. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that inserted. There we go. Step two is to rotate until we get to the witness mark, which is a little asterisk, which is just this guy here. So we're just gonna go, there's a release to go backwards, so that's a good thing. Next step says load 10 darts. So here we go. We're gonna load one at a time. One, two. Well, that's a little tricky, isn't it? Three, four, 9, and 10. Then it says we're gonna go 2 clicks to the right, so I assume it's clicks and not full rotations. One, nope. What have I done? Oh, and then load 2 more, okay? So I'm basically topping off. So I went 2 clicks, then I'm going 2 more. What does that mean? I lock it. I need a pin. I need a loading pin. There's a pin that needs to go in here to lock the top stack in place. Aha. So we'll put this pin in here. This is, in theory, will lock us. Nope, now I've broken it. Next step is turn 3 clicks, load 3. Ah, okay. I didn't have it quite in the right spot. So we're gonna put 3 darts in. Oh my gosh, I'm understanding the mechanism more and more the more I play with it. Next step is 2 clicks. And then we'll put 3 more in, and we basically repeat this 11 times. So this is 33 more darts going in. There are these sets of fins, and each one has essentially 3 of them. 3 darts go in between each grouping. What a fascinating design. What an interesting door. I'm going to explore. I see how it works. Well, that's clever. So each time, 2 clicks, then open the little door. I don't know if I can leave the door open the whole time. I might be able to. But each time it's 3 more darts in. I'm gonna close it anyway. I feel, well, let's find out. Oh, I can do it without. There we go. Okay, 3 more. What I love about this hobby is the fact that people do stuff that is not practical, would never be a product. It's very, very cool. It's neat to see innovation. It's neat to see people try to do things that haven't been done before. I expect I would get faster at this, but due to the nature of how this is loaded, you literally cannot load this on the battlefield. At least not while you're out in play without some substantial setup. I'm just imagining all the hours that went into making this. There's so many things to get right for this to actually function. Repeat this 11 times, load 3 in. Then we take the lock out. Now that I'm here, I can pull this lock out, or the tool, or no, this lock. Oh, I'm doing it wrong. And then finally, load 3 more down from the top. Wait a minute. This can't be right. I don't know what I've done, but I don't think this is gonna fire. Little addendum here. I got it fully loaded and then realized that the follower was in between the first set of rounds and the last ones. So I've gone back and fixed that. So I might have loaded this slightly differently than instructed, but we are now at the correct point and I'm gonna go back and reload this. So we'll make that hopefully fast for you, the viewer. We are now at the final step of getting our last couple darts in the end here. So I've repeated 11 times of 3, and now I'm putting the final 3, and then we are at 50 rounds, and now they should go all the way around. And then lastly, I believe I get to release the key. So in theory, I have a loaded 50-round drum mag. We're gonna grab momentum and give this a little test fire. Probably only once, because I don't wanna load it again right now. I'm gonna start off on semi-automatic, because why not? It's kind of fun. Feels good too. I love watching the actual parts move. That's kind of cool. That went too quick. So it took me probably 10 minutes to load it. I think I could get that down to, I don't know, 5 minutes or something. I'd be really curious how fast people can load those, but they disappear rather quickly. It's worth noting there are some different options on this magazine. There are different length necks depending on which blaster you're putting them into. Momentum, for example, has a really short magwell, so there's tons of room there. And then the followers change size with each of the different sizes. And this is the smallest and this is the largest. And then interestingly, the actual directions change as well, because the number of clicks and turns you do and the number of darts you load is different, but at least the instructions come with the neck of the magazine. I think this is just a absolute bonkers mod and a lot of engineering and time and love that went into this. It might be fun to take out as your very first magazine when you jump onto the field for the day or for the round and then ditch it for some regular stick mags, but I can load these so quickly, it's hard to see myself carrying a couple of these, though I do love the 50 round capacity. Thank you again, EZE Mods, for sending this over to me. I can't wait to see what you do next. This is very, very cool. You can buy these in kit form directly on his website. They are going for $95 Singaporean dollars, and US, that's about $74, depending on the exchange rate. That's about what I would expect, because there are a lot of parts here, and keep in mind, that's the kit that you have to assemble and build yourself. I'll have all the links down in the description, and if you're looking for more firing demos of these, I know my buddy Captain Xavier did a number of videos firing these through a variety of different blasters. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, I'm out of darts.